Hi guys, it's Micah. Today I'm back with Distress versus Alkoi Inks. And Distress Inks, refills, and ink pets. And you can see here the results. So, thank you for watching. No, yeah. I taped down a piece of water art paper, which is normal paper. Watercolor paper. It's not the best and not the worst. And I'm using my favorite Distress Inks. Rainbow, yeah, don't look at that, that's old. I'm starting with candied apple and I'm just smooshing it on the acetate and then spritzing it with water. And my acetate is actually a bit too big, I think, for this technique, because I kind of like it when the edges are a little bit free still or muddled, and you will see that later. And but it's fine, I should have got it smaller, but this is a piece of acetate that I had, so I use it. With the acetate you can place it on the paper and then kind of move it around with your finger a little bit. Mustard seed, twisted citron I've used as well, mowed lawn, kind of like a combo, because twisted citron is a bit too yellow and mowed lawn is a bit too dark, so together I thought they would do well. And I salted the ocean, chipped sapphire, wilted violet, and raspberry. See, I thought they would mingle or mix a little bit, but they didn't. See, and I just move it up and down and push it and pull it and kind of make it dense across the paper. It's really cool. And then you can make these as big as you want, of course. And I just, this is normal metric card size, 10 by 15 centimeters. And then depending on how much water you add and how much ink pad, of course, the results vary. And that's why I also did it with refills, because I thought that would be much more comparable to the aqua inks. And yes, it was too wide. I just wiped it off a little bit and you can see, I push it, and then I heat set it off camera. It took a while, quite a lot of water. And for the alcohol inks, I've used red pepper, sunset orange, lemonade, meadow, mermaid, sailboat, eggplant, and raspberry. And so I don't have all the colors, of course. And here's what I thought, I'd do the same, but on Yupo paper, but the paper is slick and the acetate as well, and they stuck together, so I kind of did ink smooshing instead of striping. And here you can see it with the orange, that it just gets stuck together. So I thought, I'm doing it differently, but wiping that off, that's a nice ink smooshing. I've done that before as well on my channel, of course, but I'm just putting all the colors in one, which that was quite exciting, well, nerve-wracking I should say. And the green, that was fun, it looks like a old-fashioned 80s rock guitar, can you see that? This is so cool. And I also see music notes and stuff, but might be me. But and instead of water, of course, I spritzed it with alcohol ink, and I did put a little bit more yellow because that didn't seem to be enough. And then I spritzed it as much straight from above, so not to displace the inks. And then with my finger I try to move it around, and then I pull it off towards the top so that you don't, you know, slide across the Yupo again. And there was enough left for a second one, and that's a bit more faded. I like the bright ones, that's really cool. So see, in one fell swoop I just pull it up or down. So you know, you don't get that what I had with the red and orange in the beginning, that it just dense together. And yeah, this dries of course a little bit quicker. This is why I taped this down, because that's this thinner paper. This is schut 300 grams, and I've done that without taping it down and it stays okay. Where it went through, that was actually alcohol ink. It says the same bottle but different washi tape, so I didn't pay attention. And I think the paper makes a difference, the ink of course makes a difference, and I thought, well, let's try it with distress refills. Now I used almost the same colors, except I used mermaid because I don't have the ocean for that one, and I didn't use chipped sapphire. I thought that was plenty, and there was tumbled glass. I thought that doesn't go in there. And it's kind of the same. I'm putting the acetate on top of the paper, so the, as I say, the stripes smaller. I think it's nicer. And of course, the stress refills are much more concentrated than the ink pads, so you would get a brighter result, I would say. And I could have, I think I could have done 4 prints out of this one piece of ink. One appliance? No, that's not good. One application. And you see above again brown. You have to be careful with the rainbow colors, of course. But look how cool. And I thought 2 is enough for now. Making more of a mess. And then, yeah, you can still move it around if you want with some more water or alcohol ink. You have to be careful with the alcohol though, because that kind of tends to not do what you think. And then I thought, let's splatter it with some acrylic paint, which is rather fun. And I think these are cool. I didn't finish them into a card, but with a really big, bold, black sentiment, any kind that you have, die cut or stamp, that will be cool. You see, this is ink smooshing. The orange turned out more like the other technique that I did, but I think this is really cool. And you can see the drips. And yeah, I prefer the first print because that's the brightest. And the one on the left with the watercolor, we see all the dots. I like that more as well. And that's what kind of what I wanted to achieve with smaller stripes. And yeah, I'm showing here the 3 pluses. I mean, how long it's color fade resistant. And it's about 100 years in a museum. And the triangle or the black square means it's opaque and semi-transparent or transparent if the square is empty. So there's a little bit little explanation there for you. And yeah, the bumpy paper might be a bit hard to stamp on, but you can use a die cut. And yeah, I like the bright ones. And you can splatter them with alcohol again or water and make a little bubbles, of course, or black even. But I went for white. And you can do gold or anything. That it's up to you. You don't have to splatter at all, but I thought that would maybe, you know, distress it a little bit more. Here you show it again. The black means it's completely opaque and semi-opaque. And the 3 pluses is the best fade resistantness. And it says under museum conditions. I don't think anyone has that at home, but there you go. Just some water to water it down, and depending on how much you water it, it's not opaque anymore. So just be careful if you want really white splatter, not to put too much water. But here's the card, and here's the ones with the distress inks that I still have to splatter and didn't fit into the screen. I wasn't completely dried it, but I like them as well. The refills more than the ink pads, I would say. But it's all fair game, and I think you might enjoy playing with them. And yeah, get inky fingers. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Until then, bye.